Hey everyone, Matt here from SoundSwitch, and in this tutorial video, we're going to be covering off the static looks feature. So let's get into it. So in this video, we're going to be explaining the static looks feature. We'll show you how to set them up and how these can be used in practice. Static looks are the same as any scene in a normal DMX software. Static looks aren't synced to the music, but rather they're used to override the autoloops and scripted tracks that are playing on your DJ system. Static looks can be used to create scenes for a first dance or a dinner service, or when you want your lights to just be static and in a particular look. The first thing we're going to need to do is jump over into edit mode and show you how the static looks are created. So here we will open edit mode. We will select our venue and we will open an auto loop and have that playing underneath. We will then open the MIDI window and select the static looks tab. Here you'll be presented with 32 different static look buttons. First, we want to edit a static look, so we'll right click on the first button and select edit. Then we'll be presented with a screen that shows all of our lights in our setup. I'll expand my gig bar move to expose all of the different features that are on this gig bar move. And I'll start by editing some colors on my wash lights. I can select all fixtures of the same type by selecting the top level, or I can go through and select individual fixtures. I can also shift select to select all, or use command and control select to select just some. I'm just going to change the light color on both of my bottom park amps. I'll first activate them so they start following the static look, and then I'll select a color. I'll increase the intensity and bring up the brightness of those lights. If you deactivate these particular fixtures, they will continue to follow the auto loop that is playing underneath. So we'll start by overriding them, and then we'll select both our top lights, activate these, select a different color. We'll choose a teal or cyan color, and we'll increase the intensity. Now we'll do the same thing for the gig bar move, but this time we'll activate them all and we'll select a pink or magenta color. And we'll increase the intensity. And we'll select some gobos for both the left and right mover, as well as some derby rotations. Perfect. I want to just change the color of my pars to match the color on the wash lights on the left and right trusses. I'm also going to select a position. Here I'll choose stage left and stage right. If you need to edit the positions, you can do so here. I can select my movers and point them in the direction that I want them to shine. Cool. I'm happy with that. I now have multiple colors selected and multiple intensities. I might just dim the brightness of my pars on the trusses to be halfway, and I might select to turn the strobe lights on my gig bar move. So here I will lift up the white and I can turn those on. And then I can set the strobe for the gig bar move. Now my lights are all strobing. Perfect. I can then turn that on and my new static look will start to play back. I'll just go in and turn off all of the strobing and I'll rename this to be blue and magenta. Now I can turn that static look on and off and it will override the particular auto loop. Now, what if I want to have some of my lights still following the auto loop and others following the static look? I'll just switch back to the main screen and I'll change over to a different auto loop and I'll press play. And now you can see that the auto loop is playing back on my lights. I'll then open another static look to edit it and I'll call this one wash light overwrites. I'll keep my gig bar move unselected because I want this to follow the auto loop, and I'll override all of my wash lights and set them to be a standard pink color with a 73% intensity. I can turn that static look on now, and as you can see, my wash lights on either side of my DJ booth are staying on while the gig bar move continues to follow the auto loop. If I switch back to the main screen and change to a different auto loop, we can now see that the gig bar is following the different auto loop while the static looks are still controlling the wash lights. If you're using the gig bar move venue that is shipped with the Sound Switch software, all of the static looks are pre-created for you. You can turn on all of the white strobes, or you can choose the purple setup, which has all of the lights on the gig bar purple, except the derbies, which will be orange. So that's the static looks feature. If you have any questions or you need any help setting up static looks, please reach out in the comment section below, or send an email to support@soundswitch.com, or join the Facebook group. And you can also reach out on Instagram or Facebook Messenger. Thanks, and we hope you like this video, and we'll see you in the next one.